Kathy, I've got two different bridge pads here. I want to experiment a little with him and see which is going to work best for him.
Okay.
You'll take a feel on that. You'll see they're made of memory foam.
Oh, yeah.
Very soft. And memory foam, once it warms up, will compress almost to nothing where there's pressure, and it'll stay sort of full where there isn't pressure. So this is to help take out the bridging in a saddle. You're going to use it along with your regular saddle pad.
Okay.
And one thing I will mention about memory foam is it is temperature sensitive, and you probably won't worry about that too much here in Arizona. But if you're in a colder climate, it will get hard when it's cold. But once you put it on the horse's body heat warms it up, and then it softens up quite a bit.
Okay.
So we've got, you'll see, these are called shoulder pads, and so shoulder bridge pads. So they go behind the shoulder of the horse specifically to fill in this gap and this little bit of a dip here. And so we're going to set it clear back here behind the shoulders. And we've got a short one and a long one. Now, in general, the shorter one's going to be used on a short backed horse and the longer on a long backed horse.
Okay.
That's just a general rule of thumb. Not going to be 100% of the time, because it depends on the issue we're trying to pad out. Because we've clearly got rubbing going on back here, my thinking is that the long shoulder pad is going to work a little bit better for him. So we're bringing the padding clear back to just in front of this rub mark, so it'll give a little lift to the saddle. Now, we also would use this longer one on a horse that had very prominent withers and we wanted the whole saddle to lift up, or a horse that didn't have a lot of flesh in the back. And your horse actually does not have a lot of flesh in the back. Let me see if I can get him to stand up straight. Well, you can, at times when he's standing, he just straighted one foot from the other, you can actually see the end of his backbone sticking up a little bit here. So on a fatter, fleshier horse, the musculature or the fat deposits would cause a dimple in the back. So when you have a horse with less flesh, he may need a little extra padding.
Okay.
So I'd like to try him with a saddle with this long shoulder pad, and we'll see how that works on him.
Okay.
So Kathy, this is the long shoulder bridge pad, which I think is going to be the best shape for him. We won't know for sure until we actually try it on it and you get to ride in it and see how he feels, see if he feels more comfortable to you. We're going to use any of the bridge pads in conjunction with your regular saddle pad.
Okay.
But I wouldn't use a real thick pad. I prefer, this is one of my saddle pads. It's a 3/4 inch wool felt. That's my preference for pads. Wool felt is sort of time tested with horses, and it works great in both cold climates and warm climates. It's a natural fiber, so it absorbs sweat. And the thing I like most about it is the fibers will actually slightly rearrange to conform to the horse's back. This pad's pretty new, but you can already see, you can sort of see the hollow out behind his shoulders here. So it's only been ridden in a couple of times and it's already starting to take its shape. So it will shape specifically to the horse's back that you use it on.
Okay.
The bridge pads you can use either on top of or below your regular saddle pad. Either way is fine. I rather prefer to have it on top of the pad. Particularly sometimes this, on a real sensitive horse, if this line is underneath them, they'll feel that.
Okay.
So here it'll sort of even out a little bit more in the smooth surfaces to the horse's back. But also, once I throw that saddle up there, I like to be able to see where this pad is to make sure it's in the correct place. A little bit off could make a big difference to him.
Okay.
So I want to line up this seam in the middle with the seam on the saddle pad. And remember, we're trying to fill in the hollow space and the dip here. So this is going to sit pretty far back behind the withers, just like this. Where you're getting the rubbing is right about here. So I'm hoping that that will help just provide a little bit of insulation here so there's not so much pressure.
Okay.
And our main goal is that the tree starts contacting the horse's back right in here.
Okay.
Now, the saddles that you've been using on him are, they're older saddles and they're traditional wooden tree. meaning that the tree is very rigid. And saddle trees are made to fit an average shaped horse. So they come in regular widths and wide widths, but they don't really adjust to the individual characteristics of the horse's back. And so unless you have a horse that has a totally average back, a rigid tree is, it may not fit him just right. And I think what you're, the bridging you're dealing with is in part due to the rigidness of the tree.
Okay.
I would like to try one of my saddles on him that has a flexible tree. And the flex to tree, so the bars of the tree sit here and on the other side. So in, there's a slight amount of flex to the tree. They're not noodly or anything. They still will distribute weight. But once you sit in the saddle, once you cinch it up and sit in it, the bars of the tree will flex and conform to the horse's back. So you'll find it fits a lot more horses. And if the horse isn't quite average enough in the back that a rigid tree fits him just right, a slight flex in the tree may take out the problem. So I really think with him, it's not a hugely dramatic problem when you look at it. Obviously, the white marks tell us there's a big problem going on there for him. But I think that between the flexible tree and a bridge pad to fill in these gaps here, that he's going to be a lot more comfortable. And hopefully we can actually get rid of those white marks.
Okay.